Are you spending too much money on ads? And are you trying to put in so much effort to convince people to buy your courses and programs? Well, having affiliates who do the promotion for you and who also lend you their trust and their recommendation can really solve all of those problems for you. I'm Natalie Lussier, founder of AccessAlly, and on this channel, you're going to learn how to scale your business using technology and other online marketing strategies. When I first started my online business and I was selling online courses, I was doing everything myself. I was marketing, selling, and delivering my online courses. And let me tell you, as soon as I stopped working, the sales stopped coming in too. Eventually, I decided to create an affiliate program to incentivize people to help promote my courses and my products. And the results were pretty spectacular. I started getting new customers on a regular basis. Instead of having to launch all the time, I would wake up to sales in my inbox. And the best part is that these new customers were a lot like my best customers because they already trusted me, they were motivated, and because they came from a recommendation, they were ready to get started and take action on what my courses were all about. And that made a huge difference in the results they were getting, the testimonials I got, and just the quality of the customers in my business. And even to this day, my business still benefits so much from having an affiliate program. And I've learned so much along the years of what makes an affiliate program successful and how to have it set up so that your affiliates really promote and really get a benefit so that it's win-win with you and your affiliates too. So here's what you need to know about how to set up an affiliate program successfully from the get-go. So number one is you have to design your affiliate program commission structure so that it's sustainable for you and your business. So you need to take a look at what your profit margins are like right now, how much you're spending on advertising and also delivering your courses and products. What your fixed costs are will tell you a lot about how much you can offer to affiliates. Now, the most important thing to keep in mind is that you don't pay affiliates unless they make the sale for you. So unlike advertising or other things that you're doing for marketing, you don't pay unless you have income coming in. So that can also make it a little bit easier to give people a good percentage when they're recommending you. So I've seen affiliates offer anything from 5%, 10, 15, 30%, all the way up to 50%. And that tends to be pretty common when it comes to online courses and memberships where there's not as much of a delivery to it. But hold up, I've even seen affiliates give 100% commission on the first sale. So maybe you have a lower price point and you just want to get as many buyers as possible and you really want people who are committed and who are going to hit that buy button and not just subscribers. You could give people 100% commission on that first sale and that way you're going to get a lot of people promoting you because they're essentially able to make money without having to create their own products and services. So that's an incredible offer. And then on the back end, you could take whatever 100% you want from your other products and services, or maybe give a lower percentage on those as well. Now, this is great if you have products to upsell or cross-sell, but if you don't, make sure to watch my video all about cross-selling, upselling, and downselling, and how to design these products and services for your business. While you're at it, make sure to give this video a like if you're getting value and subscribe below because we've got more great videos every single week. Now, the other thing to keep in mind when it comes to commission structures is whether you will be giving a recurring commission on a recurring product. So you could decide how long you wanted to give a commission for. For example, maybe you give 15% on a recurring basis for the first year, or maybe you do it for the lifetime of the customer. It's totally up to you, and take a look at your numbers to see what you can afford. Number two is all about deciding what your affiliate tiers will look like. So you could have multiple affiliate tiers where top affiliates earn a little higher percentage and newer affiliates maybe have to work their way up. Now, keep in mind, when you're doing an affiliate program, 20% of your affiliates will bring in 80% of your sales, 100% of the time. So this is the 80-20 rule, and we've seen it in our business. We have our top affiliates, they're earning thousands of dollars per month, and then we have people who have never made a sale. And you will have people who sign up to your affiliate program and who get excited about it, and then they get busy with something else, and maybe they move on, or they just don't have a chance to promote. So don't worry, I have some strategies later on in the video to help people really promote you. But really what it comes down to is having incredible relationships with your affiliates. The more personal you can be with your affiliates, the more of a true relationship with give and take, the better. Because people don't wanna just be another number, another affiliate on your affiliate list. They wanna be someone who is part of your business and someone who is also going to be rewarded when they're sending people your way. Number three, create a terms and conditions agreement for your affiliates. So you'll either wanna work with a lawyer or find a template for affiliate agreements and tweak it for your particular business and your needs. But in this document, what you wanna do is lay out all the terms and how your affiliate program works. So it's super clear, your affiliates check this off before they sign up so that you know they know exactly what they're getting into when it comes to your affiliate program. So you wanna cover cases like, can your affiliates earn a commission when they purchase your product themselves? And do they need to wait if there's a refund period before they get paid? So let's say you have a 30-day, 60-day, or 90-day refund policy for your courses and products. Will they be paid after that refund period, and how long is that, so that they know when they're doing a promotion when they'll get paid? Just go ahead and explain everything in detail so that no one is confused and no one's gonna come back with questions. Number four, you wanna set up an affiliate signup process as well as your affiliate center. So this is where people will sign up to become an affiliate. You get all the details you need from them, like an email address to pay them with, all the other things you need to be compliant with tax things and all the other things that go into running a program. In the affiliate center, that's where people will get their affiliate links, any promotional materials you have for them, as well as their stats. So how they're doing. Are they sending a lot of people? Are people clicking on their links? And how many sales they're making. Now let's take a look at how AccessAlly allows you to create these gorgeous affiliate dashboards. So first of all, you decide on your commission percentage and how long you want to track. So you could give people a 90-day duration for their link or unlimited, like what we're doing here. You can also create as many affiliate links as you want, and these will show up for your people. So you can go ahead and add affiliate links. They don't even have to point to your own website. You could have them promote other social media sites of your own, but of course it's great to send people back to your site so they can actually opt in and purchase. And as a site owner, you can come in and see how your affiliates are doing, how many clicks they're sending, and manage their affiliate account as well. When it comes time to do payouts, you can generate a report and import it directly into PayPal to do a mass payment, saving you a lot of time and effort in paying your affiliates each month. To have people register, you can create a simple affiliate opt-in form. Start off by asking for their payment email and also how they want to be communicated with. And create as many sub-pages in your affiliate center as you want. You could do a page with social media graphics, maybe swipe emails or swipe social media copy. It is up to you how you want to empower your affiliates to promote. Number five, stay in touch with your affiliates. Once they sign up, that's just the beginning of your relationship with them. You wanna send them emails and reach out to them personally and really make sure that they are doing their best so that you both win together. If you're doing any launches, you'll wanna share your launch calendar. You'll wanna share when things are dropping and what they'll be able to promote so that they can start to plan ahead. Being an affiliate is a lot of work, and yes, it can be super rewarding when you're on the affiliate side because you're not doing all the work of creating the content and actually selling, but you still have to do promotion on your end. So give them as much as you can in terms of promotional headway and time, and any materials you can create for them will be better. Make yourself available so that you can be interviewed on their podcasts or do webinars with your affiliates so that you have a chance to showcase your courses and your content yourself while still leveraging the audience and the business of your affiliates. You can also have affiliate contests and leaderboards where people can compete with each other, and you can give prizes for the affiliates that bring in the most leads or the most sales. So there's so much you can do once you've set up your affiliate program, and I cannot wait to hear what it is that you create with your affiliates in tow. So to recap, you want to choose your commission structure. You'll want to decide if you have different affiliate tiers that people can graduate to. You'll want to create a streamlined signup process as well as an affiliate center. And you can incentivize and keep in touch with your affiliates with contests and other things throughout the year. AccessAlly has built-in affiliate management capabilities, which means you can create your affiliate signup process, your affiliate center, and have people log into just one place. So if you don't know, having your existing customers customers and students become affiliates is one of the best ways to grow because they already know and love you, they've taken your courses, they know your content and your brand and your style, and they're probably friends with the exact same kinds of people as they are, so they have a network of people who would probably be interested in your content too. So that's a huge way to get started to your affiliate program, and with AccessAlly, people can be logged into their courses and in one click, become an affiliate and start sharing your content. Now, if you're not sure if you should be creating online courses or memberships, or if you have both and you're not sure which one to have your affiliates promote, make sure to watch my video all about online courses versus memberships to see what's best for you and your business and how things can kind of cross-sell and promote each other too.